few moments left. Fidel Castro, who is not a capitalist, yesterday you said capitalism is the major problem in the world. Fidel Castro was critical of you for denying the Holocaust. He said that Iran should try to understand the unique history of anti-Semitism. How do you respond to Castro? Certainly not a friend of Israel.
A site related to the Zionist regime issued this news. Mr. Castro sent a message to me yesterday and said that it was untrue, this statement, that his statements were interpreted differently, that he had said something different. So I have no opinion here on this statement, but I'd like to ask, why is there so much insistence in the United States to absolutely defend the Zionist regime? What is the relationship between the U.S. government, 10,000 kilometers across the ocean from the Zionist regime, and the need to support it? Why is it so sensitive?
Because a massive group of people were annihilated just for being what they were. 7 million were killed, 8 million. So as a humanitarian country, we care about this. And many Jews came here to live, and many Jews created a country in Israel and want to live in peace, don't you? Now, Castro did say you should recognize anti-Semitism exists in the world, and we all should be concerned about it.
Is that the real issue, that the U.S. government wants to defend human rights?
Of course.
Well, where were these people killed? Were they killed in Palestine by the hands of Palestinians?
It doesn't matter where they were killed, it's that fact that they were killed.
Then it's all right for a million Iraqi people to be killed, and then it would be okay if they decide to come and occupy the United States? They were killed in Iraq. Would you allow them to come occupy the United States and
take over? You're not saying the United States committed genocide. You're saying the United States committed genocide?
That's a separate discussion. And yes, it did happen in both Iraq and Afghanistan. But that's a separate issue. I'd like to ask you, if in a country someone's right is violated, they are oppressed, assuming that your assumption, your statement is correct, well, does that imply that they can go and occupy another land? Is there any logic in that? If we were to follow that logic, will there be any security left in the world? In World War II, 100 million or 80 million people were killed. If they were to go occupy 20 countries around the world, that would have been terrible.
The land was legally created.
So the question is, you see, come, the question. You just said yourself it's over the Holocaust. Why are you changing your statement? My question is, what are the interests of the United States to in absolutely defending them? There are many parts of the world where human rights are violated. Do you know how many American Indians were killed? Do you know or not?
I know.
I mean, you're a reporter. You should have the answers to this.
We're out of time. We'll pick this up next year with the president of Iran. I'm Larry King. Don't forget.